Hello guys, how are you?
Stop going onto people's live streams and asking how are you. We live, we streaming, other people are watching, the room is not on fire, things are okay. Just comment on what's happening. Ask someone else in the chat how they are doing if you want small talk. Every time I say, I'm good, how are you? I feel a little puke in the back of my throat rise up. It's actually painful responding to that question while I know other people who are watching for 45 minutes heard me say it 36 times at all. To all the people before you came up in here with Joe Small Talk. I love you guys. I know no one does this to be annoying. It's just one of those formalities that is so motherfucking unnecessary on this format. Nice save there at the end. Hopefully this tweet doesn't blow up and you get a lot of shit for it. Oh, never mind. Okay, so this person is named Fleek and she is a Just Chatting Twitch streamer. The objective of said category is to start a conversation with the streamer. And typically you open a conversation by saying, how was your day? So suggesting that that's vomit inducing is pretty strange. And a lot of people tended to agree. Asmongold responded to this tweet by saying, the truth is that a lot of people who seek out interactions with streamers in a small talk kind of way are doing so because they are inexperienced with socializing and practicing. I think it's a good thing, and I try to be as accommodating with them as possible. I like how he basically just said Twitch chat is all autistic or socially underdeveloped. God, that's so demeaning. Dolan Dark responds to her by saying, how are you? Jesse says, entitlement at its fullest. Basically saying, you are even lucky I'm streaming, don't talk to me. Lonely Goomba replies to her by saying, pretty small problem to have. If they are in the room watching, you got a viewer. Least you can do is either ignore the message or spend 2 seconds replying. This is just making people feel bad for watching, really. Could be getting like actual hate thrown at you in the chat. Weiss responds to her by saying, huh? To which Clark's lover responds, how are you doing this fine evening, streamer man Weiss? G2 Pengu responds to her by saying, how are ya? Showing a tweet that she made a mere 6 hours ago, announcing that she's live on Twitch, and following it up with, how are ya? Lobos Jr. responds to her by saying, please come say hi and ask how I am. Sorokor says, Twitch streamers when they ask them how their day went, showing a picture of a ravenous creature. The Black Hawk Age says, the irony of this terrible take is because of all the backlash she's catching. I know she's deep down wishing someone would have asked how she's doing right now. Example 4002 of why I don't talk to a lot of streamers. Straight weirdos. Daniel responds to Fleek by saying, how is this actually someone's thought process? Julian responds to Fleeksy by saying, damn bro, your fans care about you. That sucks so much. I'm sorry to hear that. She then quote tweets him and says, for real, tell them to shut the fuck up. Like, goddamn! Anyways, going live soon. Angela DeFrost responds to her by saying, I feel like you are the only streamer in the world that has issue with this. She quote tweets her and says, baby, I'm a different breed. To which Marcus Fix My Phone responds, they was coming for you. Oh no. I enjoy the way you run the stream. It clears riffraff and time wasters. And let us enjoy what you present. Keep snapping on these folks. I legit woke up at 2 a.m. and watched 3 episodes of The Circle and had a blast. Smish Morton then responds, simp. Waifu Brianna responds to Fleeksy by saying, I'm not like other girls. I'm a different breed. To which Fleeksy responds, this was a TikTok reference, but go off. Oh, it's Baby responds to Fleeksy by saying, I would not watch your stream, just for the attitude in this tweet. Lol, Fleeksy responds, ma'am, you already don't watch my stream. And that's okay, lol. If you get your own stream, you can run it however you want. Settler Sammy responds to Fleeksy by saying, if you have to walk on eggshells when I'm genuinely interacting with the streamer, it will literally be one less view you get to your channel. I think the phrase to go with that is not to bite the hand that ultimately feeds your account. Fleeksy responds, genuinely interacting, by asking the most disingenuous, overused, most ignored question of all time. Okay. Anthony responds to Fleeksy by saying, then what's the point if your audience doesn't have the opportunity to connect with you? Fleeksy responds, by asking me a question that warrants only one answer, which usually is just, good thanks, and close-ended? Yeah, real conversation opener there. Sinfully unethical responds to her by saying, the fact you have nothing interesting or genuine to say. Anytime I get that question, I can answer in a multiple of ways. It's okay to be boring. Just say you are boring. Lol. Don't blame a viewer and their question. You are the reason most people come in streams and lurk and don't interact. Paolo responds to Fleeksy by saying, you do know it doesn't have to be so close-ended, right? good thanks is like the driest response you can give, lol. You can really say a lot of things to that question. Drew says, how's it going? Oh hey there, Name. We are just completing some achievements for the Kingdom Hearts collection on Xbox right now, and then maybe playing some Jackbox later. Replace the answer with literally just some information beyond, I'm well, thanks. Isn't that hard? Dogger Girl responds to Fleeksy by saying, ever heard of a conversation? It's a thing, or being polite. Fleeksy responds, I don't do pleasantries, ma'am. I'm old and bitter. Katie says, be grateful you are getting engagement. This suggests that you are unappreciative of your viewers. They are just being polite. Fleeksy responds, when you become part of a community, you learn about a streamer. And guess what? Some streamers don't like small talk or pleasantries. We are not all the same. Why would you want anyone to be anyways? Run your stream how you want, and I'll continue to run mine the same. JMax says, I'm gonna be real with you. If I was in your community and saw this post, I'd have unsubbed and encouraged others to do the same. You know what I do when I'm asked how I'm doing while streaming? I answer, even if I've answered 20 times already. You are nobody without your followers. Immortals Petro responds to her by saying, listen, I know I'm not the best streamer, and I love yelling at my viewers for dumb shit, but this ain't it. Fleeksy responds, then you do you, boo. No one's telling you how to run your stream. Petro responds, I get that, but you were trying to tell people what to do when going into other streams. Fleeksy responds, if people come into my stream and the first thing they ask is anything besides, how are you? I will be very pleased on a personal level. It's surface level pleasantry I don't require to open communication up with me. But if they want to keep doing that, then who cares? The fuck, lol. 99% of people popping off are people who don't watch my shit anyways. So it's not personal. You don't have to internalize it. Just like how I don't have to listen to the incels going wild right now. C8 responds to Fleek by saying, wait, is she calling Sheila an incel? Because lol, retweet. Fleeksy responds, nah. She wouldn't know if I did. Petra responds to her by saying, I guess you could have worded it for yourself, and not speak for every person's livestream, and it could have been taken in a different manner. Or you wanted to make a semi-controversial tweet for interactions. Either way, you do you, boo. Fleeksy responds, I don't understand how not liking small talk is controversial, but I've been out of high school for 8+ years, so my days of surface-level pleasantries are behind me. Jake responds, genuinely curious, but aren't surface level pleasantries the stepping stones to deeper connections? How can anyone expect to get anywhere without starting at the beginning? Short Blasian says, I'm really hoping you have huge tits or something, cause I don't know why anyone would watch you. Fleeksy responds, you can watch my streams, and take note boo, all my VODs are saved. Speaking of which, the last couple streams that Fleeksy has done after this controversy, the VODs have been deleted, so I guess they aren't saved. Which sucks because I really wanted to know what she had to say about this on stream. Either way, Nicholas DiOrio responds to her by saying, 6 months later, stop going into McDonald's and asking how are you? We flip burgers, we working, other people are eating, the room is not on fire. Things are okay, just tell me your order. Ask someone else in the establishment how they are doing if you want small talk. Snowbird responds to Fleeksy by saying, sounds like you need to find a hobby other than streaming, if you were this profoundly annoyed by people greeting you when they join your stream. E-girl investor responds to him by saying, LOL? Entitled ass bitch, what the fuck? Fleeksy responds, sure am. How are you doing? Fleeksy then quote tweets Snowbird and says, you know there's literally 100 other ways to greet people? Google is free, sweetie. Owen responds to her by saying, thanks for asking how I'm doing. I appreciate that you care enough to ask. Fleeksy responds, I'll use this as an auto response for my stream element so I don't have to repeat it 100 times. Owen responds, don't. To which Fleeksy responds, I'ma put Owen, to credit your immaculate genius too. Owen responds, I don't know why it's so fucking hard to be nice to people. Fleeksy responds, it's because you're not smoking enough weed. To which Owen responds, dude, at this point, the weed's smoking me. Fleeksy replies, it's smoking that dirt from 2003 then. Owen then responds, your reading comprehension isn't the best, I guess. Snowbird quote tweets Fleeksy and says, I know this harlot did not track this tweet down and then call me sweetie. Fleeksy then quote tweets him again and says, number one, had to track your subtweeting. Scared to at me, hiding behind an anime photo ass, it was in plain sight, unlike your package, which has inverted into a vag after years of no activity besides your hand. My socials are free for everyone though, so you can stay as long as you want, baby. Tiz responds, his ass is not even reading. To which Fleeksy responds, that's weird. because he was reading when he was screenshotting to all his little anime profile friends. Stove responds, "This is exactly why you shouldn't be a streamer. You talk to and about others like they are below you. I hope your streaming career takes a swan dive into a garbage fire that matches your terrible personality." Fleeksy responds, "Not the anime accounts of Twitter trying to gatekeep live streaming and telling women how to respond to trolls, laughing my fucking ass off. Crazy that I can be a woman with thoughts, feelings, and responses, huh?" Stove responds, "So having an anime profile picture just means I'm misogynistic? Interesting. Sorry your feelings are fragile. It's not really because you are a woman. It's because you are just human scum. Maybe just learn to take criticism and be nicer." Fleeksy responds, "My feelings are so hurt. I think I'm gonna change my profile pic to an anime photo for a week or two." Shiro responds, "You got them good there, Fleeksy. I think if you repeat the anime profile pic argument once more, it's gonna start becoming somewhat effective." Stove then responds, "Bro, I'm literally shaking. I'm trembling. Tears won't stop falling out of my eyes. That's it. This is how my story ends. It's over for me. This is how I die." Snowbird quote tweets Fleeksy and says, "Yes, I, Supreme Leader Snowbird, eternal emperor of my domain, was scared to add a Dixie ignoramus, who doesn't like being greeted while streaming. My phallus is of no concern to you. Although, I will note that trying to read your tweets caused my genitals to retract up into my body." Fleeksy responds by saying, "They were already nicely tucked inside. Right next to where you keep your misogyny. Stop playing. My opinions and feelings are expressed with zero expectations of other people validating, echoing, or resonating with them. I know, mind-blowing how we can all have different feelings, thoughts, and takes on situations. It's almost as if we are all individual people? Lol, people with no stream or 15 viewer Andy streams telling me how to run mine. Don't quit your day jobs, and don't come for my wig if what you are doing isn't working for you. Maybe it's because you ask everyone close-ended, meaningless questions and think it's caring. Welcome to Twitch, where teeny bopper misogynistic boys want to tell women what they should be doing and how.
Wah, bitch!
Stick to chasing internet clout and using pleasantries that work in high school settings. Clearly it's working for you since you have so much to say. Let me add women with internal misogyny too. Hehe, since y'all ain't slick either. And I can see the,
I just wanna be one of the boys,
energy from the way you're eager to chime in. Ooh, a woman on the internet who shares her honest thoughts, has opinions, and claps back? As people who see women with no other value than just being pretty and acting like an AI program, I see why this would upset you. P.S. Fuck no. I'm not a role model. My stream is 18 plus and up. If you landed in my territory, it's because the parental block your mommy put on your computer broke. I don't want to see none of y'all tweeting mental health shit for the rest of the month, with the way you can't handle people having opinions and preferences that are different from yours. Hating small talk is controversial. Who knew?
I'm very honored to be in the presence of so many locals.
Brick Blocks responds to her by saying, "Imagine having this much of an ego. Settle down." Fleeksy responds, "Big ego, bigger ass." Dobie Cryptids responds, "I fucking love you." To which Vibin responds, "Bro, what? That comeback was lame." Fleeksy then tweets out, "Me getting ready to go live, knowing everyone gonna come in asking, how are you? You guys are funny, and I appreciate the laughs." Corwin responds, "Hop in. We're gonna go find out who asked." Varther responds, "To be fair, I responded with that copy-paste of your hot take. While I think it was a bit shit, I don't think you deserve this much backlash for it. World's gone a bit mad." Fleeksy quote tweets him and says, "I'm used to people sensationalizing whatever I do or say. It's all good." She then tweets out a video with the caption, "It's been living in March for months now. Thanks for asking."
You know, there's all that, "Oh, hi, how was your day?" And I think, fuck off. What are you talking about? How was my day? My day has got absolutely nothing to do with you.
And that is about it for everything in regards to this small little controversy. Ultimately, not that big of a deal, but I found it pretty funny. If you enjoyed it too, be sure to subscribe with notifications on because there's more where that came from, and follow me on Twitter to find out what I'm saying over there. Thank you so much to my channel members in particular, Sushi Joe, Forever Ghoul, The Dank Memes Play, Turtle, and Azorich for $30 a month, Rubybox Fox for $40 a month, and Boar for $50 a month. This helps me out immensely, I appreciate it a lot. And with all that being said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.